Please welcome to the stage, Kathleen McGee.
This is fun. This is super fun. Stand-up comedy is fun. It's the best job I've ever had. It's great. It's amazing. I love doing stand-up because you get to travel a lot. The best show that I got to do so far of my career was on Valentine's Day in Las Vegas at the world's largest swingers club. Yes, it was amazing. And after the show, I had to go to the bathroom. And in order to go to the bathroom in this place, you have to go through this fucking room. And yeah, I'm not saying fucking to make the joke edgy, people. Literally, it was a fucking room. It was a room with tables and chairs and pommel horses, and everybody was fucking. And I didn't know what to do, so I just finger banged myself in the corner. I didn't want to join in, but I didn't want to be the prude at the swingers club either. This is a fun night tonight. I love living in Toronto. When I first moved to Toronto, my friend wanted me to take a self-defense course with her because she said that self-defense was a great form of exercise and the number one prevention of rape, which was weird because I always thought the number one prevention of rape was a polite yes. It confuses them, you know? Nothing turns a rapist off more than agreement. They lose their boner. As soon as you're like, let's do this, they're like, well, I don't want to fuck you anymore. This isn't fun for me, whatever. I didn't smoke a lot of pot when I lived out west, but now I live in Toronto. I love pot because I found it super fun. It's really fun to smoke pot. I was at a party and there was a bong, and I've never used a bong before, and they passed it to me first, and I didn't know what to do, so I just finger banged myself in the corner. It's just sort of my go-to move when I'm confused. You want to see something really hot? Give me a hard math problem in the corner. I didn't know how to round. Give me some lube. I'm drying up here. Sorry. No, I didn't finger bang myself at that party, but I did take the bong, and I didn't want to look like an idiot that never used a bong before, so I didn't ask how to use it. I just was like, yeah, let's toke this shit up. Oh. And I totally deep-throated that bong. And I got super fucking high. And three guys asked me out, so it was a really good night for me. Pretty awesome. I have a lot of trouble with guys, you know. You know, in like relationships when sex gets boring and sex gets lame, you want to spice it up a little bit. I was with this guy and he had this idea that we should have stranger sex. So we wanted to go to a bar and pretend we didn't know each other and pick each other up, you know, spice it up a little bit. So I went to the bar and he was sitting there. I sat next to him. We started talking. He bought me a drink. What a gentleman. You know, we had a couple of conversations. I felt comfortable. We had a lot in common. And I took him home and we had the craziest sex of our relationship. It was the best thing that we could have ever done. So I called him the next day and I was like, oh my God, that was amazing. How did you dress up like two black guys? That was fucking awesome. Okay. You know, 'cause I like black guys. I'll admit it. I do. I'm from Alberta. I didn't know they existed. Now I'm in Toronto, they make me feel sexy all the time, you know? They say things like, you're beautiful just the way you are. They say, go ahead, have that second hot dog. You know, pay for it, but you can have it. You know, I'm used to dumb white guys saying shit to me like, well, have you tried puking? Well, if your cock was big enough to make me gag, I might puke. Chad. Whatever. I never get picked up at the bar, but I did one night. It was actually kind of exciting because it was romantic, too. This guy stumbled up to me, and he looked me straight in the breasts. And he was like, oh. Listen, I don't mean to be a cunt, but you are beautiful. And I just looked at him and I said, shh, You had me at cunt. Because I live for romance, I do. I like romance.